Good afternoon. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
And welcome to the special meeting of the reorganization of the mayor and council here in the borough of Fanwood. We will start off by reading the Open Public Meetings Act. I hereby announce and request that such be included in the minutes of this meeting, that notice of the time, place, and date of this meeting has been prominently posted on the bulletin board at Borough Hall, mailed to the Times, Star Ledger, the Courier News, the Alternative Press by January 10th, 2017, filed with the borough clerk, and mailed to any person requesting the same in accordance of the Open Public Meetings Act. For everyone that's here, I'd like for you to stand so we can see the flags.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I'd ask that you remain standing as we have this morning's invocation read by Father Michael Ward of Immaculate Heart of Mary in Scotch Plains.
Thank you, Mayor. God of all nations, Father of the human family, we give you thanks for the freedom we exercise and the many blessings of democracy we enjoy in these United States of America. We ask for your protection and guidance for all who devote themselves to the common good, working for justice and peace at home and around the world. We lift up our duly elected leaders and public servants, those who will serve us as president, as legislators, and judges, those in the military and law enforcement. Unite us, O Lord, with a common purpose, dedication, and commitment to achieve liberty and justice in the years ahead for all people, especially those who are most vulnerable in our midst. Assist with your spirit of counsel and fortitude, wisdom and understanding, our mayor, newly elected council members Kathy and Tom, and all council members and civic leaders in Fanwood. May they always seek the ways of justice, truth, and mercy. Grant that they may be enabled by your powerful protection to lead our community with honesty and integrity. We ask this, your blessing, God of power and might, wisdom and justice, now and always.
Amen. Thank you. Well, I want to thank all of you for coming out today and helping us welcome back Kathy Mitchell and Tom Krantz as they will get sworn in any minute. But I would like to just acknowledge a few special guests that we have in the audience. Our very own freeholder, Al Mirabella, is here. Good morning to you. We're lucky to have actually two women who will be serving Garwood quite capably. I have Councilwoman Sarah Tedesco here in the audience, and Councilwoman-elect, she just won her own election, Jen Blumenstock, who will get sworn in shortly. I'd like to welcome John Stewart, who is the Chief of Staff to Adrian Mapp in our neighbor in Plainfield, where we have a wonderful recent shared service with the Plainfield Municipal Utility Authority to provide our curbside recycling, which has been a home run, both from a financial point of view and as well as a service point of view. So thank you for that. I have two really good friends of mine here, Chris Capodice, who's the Springfield chairman over in Springfield, the Democratic chairman, and Dan Petrosky, the chairman in Roselle Park. I want to thank you for that. We also have people here that come here every day and work very hard for you. Dan Weiss, our capable library director, is in the audience. Bob Budiansky, Bruce Helmstetter, who has served all of us as a code official, who will be retiring at the end of January. So we thank him for coming out today, and we wish him luck in the future. Ray Sullivan, our very capable zoning officer, who's done some tremendous work in 2016 in our development. Joe Nagy. Joe Nagy, it's good to see you. He is our long-serving historic preservation commissioner. Former Councilman Mike Such, I believe, is here in the audience and a recreation commissioner. I want to thank him for coming out as well. And of course, Chief Trigo and your men, thank you for everything that you do. Chief Piccola and your men, thank you. And for everyone that's here on the rescue squad, who we will also be swearing. My apologies if I did not pick up anybody else here in the audience. We're here this morning, this afternoon, to swear in two people who have served this community quite capably. We will first give the oath of office to Kathy Mitchell, who is going into her seventh term. So we're going to give her a nice who has the distinction of serving four mayors and being our longest-serving elected official in this community, in the history of family, which is no small feat, so we appreciate that. And also, we will be welcoming back Tom Krantz, who has jumped in his first term, has agreed to run for re-election, and they both did very well, as they both ran unopposed. So that's always a good thing. So I'm going to walk over here and do the oath of office, and then they will join us up here. Kathy, please bring forward anybody that you wish to. Your crew?
My crew.
Your crew. Come on, crew.
Come on, Felicia.
Okay. Who would you like to hold the Bible?
I don't know. I think my assistant here would like
okay,
to hold the, you want to hold the Bible for me?
Hold the Bible.
Okay. Come on in.
Come on in. Scoot in.
Excuse me, ma'am. If you stand over there by the podium, it would be a much everybody in.
Okay. So, is this better?
It is, but everybody really close.
So I need Kathy over here.
Yes.
Okay. We'll switch.
Not that I don't care for you guys, but.
Okay.
That's good. The end is right there.
Okay. There you go.
Ready?
That works.
Ready?
Yes, much better.
Okay. Please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Catherine Mitchell.
I, Catherine Mitchell.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution.
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And that I will bear true faith and allegiance.
And that I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the same.
To the same.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And in this state.
And in this state.
Under the authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
I do further solemnly swear.
I do further solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully.
That I will faithfully.
Impartially.
Impartially.
And justly perform.
And justly perform.
All the duties.
All the duties.
Of the office of councilwoman.
Of the office of councilwoman.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Okay, come on over here with me.
Okay, I'd like to call forward Tom Krantz.
It's just two of us this time.
Is there okay?
Not as much of a challenge.
Ready?
Yep.
I, Tom Krantz.
I, Tom Krantz.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And that I will bear true faith and allegiance.
And that I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the same.
To the same.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And in this state.
And in this state.
Under the authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
I do further solemnly swear.
I do further solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully.
That I will faithfully.
Impartially.
Impartially.
And justly perform.
And justly perform.
All the duties.
All the duties.
Of the office of councilman.
Of the office of councilman.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Welcome back, Kathy and Tom. And now, I believe, Eleanor, we have the presentation of the election certificate.
Just to certify that you've been elected. We have a certificate of election.
Thank you very much.
Kathy, here's yours.
Yeah, we're on your walls then.
thank you.
Yeah, exactly. Your seventh one. We have a few special presentations since this is actually a very special day for us. I'd like to call forward, I believe, is it Tom Plant, who represents the Fanwood Democratic Committee?
Thank you, Mayor. Happy New Year to all.
Happy New Year.
On behalf of the Fanwood Democratic Committee, I'm here today to congratulate Kathy Mitchell and Tom Prance on their reelection to another term on the council. Councilwoman Mitchell and Councilman Prance are well known to the people of Fanwood for their decades of service to the community, and we are happy to acknowledge that service and wish them all the best for the new term and for the new year. Kathy, I think I worked on your first campaign, so you and I both can scratch our heads and say, how many years ago was that? And Tom's newer on the council, but of course very well known to the community for his hard work with the rescue squad for many years. So we're just delighted to have them back on the council, and I know the council will be stronger for their being members of it. So on that note, I would just like to thank them, and we have some bouquets for... Sorry. Both of them.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. The Fanwood Democratic Committee has been really front and center over the years in helping to select and to elect the fine individuals that you see up here with me today. And I just want to take a moment to acknowledge Kevin Barris, who has been up here, Russell Ugel, Erin McElroy Barker, who is just starting her second year of her first term, and Councilman Jack Molinar. Please give them a round of applause. We all serve this community because we believe we can actually make a difference. We each bring our own different strength and unique capabilities here for a dollar a year. And I think it's important to note, because none of us do this for any financial gain, other than that we believe, like I said, that we each bring something that can really make a difference. And Kathy, congratulations, and Tom, you know, welcome back. I also would like to take a moment to acknowledge our very hardworking Chief Financial Officer, Fred Tompkins, who has been with me every step of the way since I got here. Eleanor McGovern, who is capable of running our day-to-day business of our borough for how many years, Eleanor? Many, many, many. Antonius is here representing TNM, who is our borough engineer, and Dan McCarthy, who serves as well as our borough attorney. We are all in very good hands. I'd like to call forward Freeholder Al Mirabella, who has a special presentation.
Thank you very much, Mayor. I want to wish you a happy new year along with the rest of the council and all the professionals and the residents and everybody assembled here at Fanwood. I also want to congratulate Tom and Kathy on their re-elections. Served the town well. As a resident, I could have walked here, but it was raining, so I didn't. I see we have a junior council member here, too, so congratulations. Maybe 2035 you'll be up here. I couldn't let this moment pass without putting together a resolution for our councilwoman, who is serving her seventh term in unprecedented fashion, the longest serving elected official in township history. And I have something for you on behalf of the freeholders. I'm not going to read it, but trust me, it says a lot of good things about you. But I want to just wish you the best, Kathy and Tom and the rest of council. I know the work that you do and the hard work that you do, and I'm the benefit as a resident, and I really appreciate all of that you do throughout the year. And Mayor, you are certainly a great partner in my day job during the day, and also just the leadership that you provide to Fanwood, the County of Union, and the state of New Jersey is just outstanding. So Mayor, thank you for all your hard work.
Thank you.
Councilwoman, this is for you.
Oh my goodness, this is very, very...
You've done a lot of good things, it's been very long.
Thank you very much. I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge that Governor DeFrancesco has walked in and is sitting back there, so Happy New Year, and thank you for... Many of you know that the governor, you know, grew up here in the Fanwood Scotch Plains area and lived in Scotch Plains for many years and has always cried the voice from the back. And has always paid attention and has been helpful to our communities at large, both the Fanwood and Scotch Plains. So we're quite honored that you joined us here today, and look forward to working with you over the next couple years. Thank you, Governor. So Mrs. McGovern, let's do the first roll call for 2017, please.
Kevin Morris.
Here.
Russell Yugo.
Present.
Tom Kranz.
Here.
Erin Northwood Walker.
Here.
Catherine Mitchell.
Here.
Beth Molinar.
Here.
Mayor Moore.
Here. Okay. First thing we're going to do is the appointment of borough officials, which is on page 5 of our... I'm sorry. Skip that over. I have the election of council president, so I would take a motion from the dais for a motion for council president.
Mayor, as the outgoing president, I would like to nominate Councilman Morris.
Second.
I have a second on that. All in favor?
Aye.
Welcome and congratulations to our new council president. The appointment of borough officials on page 5 is all of the individuals that serve us here at Borough Hall, including our Fanwood Special Officer and the Fanwood Crossing Guards. May I have a motion on that?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'm very happy now to give several oaths of office. I believe we have Dan Antonelli, who will be sworn in as our prosecutor. I'm not sure if our public defender...
No, he's ill.
He's not feeling well? Okay. I do want to acknowledge for a moment that I have our Fanwood Judge, Sue McMullen, is in the audience. I believe I saw her come in. Is she there? Oh,
yes.
She's in the back of the room. The judge, McMullen, has served the Fanwood Municipal Court quite capable, and there's something to be said as a mayor when you really get no complaints about your court system. And so with that, I'm very happy to make your reappointment to the bench, and she will actually get sworn in by another judge this coming week, I understand. So congratulations and welcome back. We'll swear in the Fanwood Fire Department officials and the Fanwood Rescue Squad. The Fanwood Fire Department, I will just make, is celebrating 127 years worth of service to our community, and the Rescue Squad is serving 69 years of the men and women, so I think that that's an important acknowledgement. So I'd like to call Dan Antonelli as the prosecutor, please. I, Daniel Antonelli.
I, Daniel Antonelli.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And the Constitution of the State of New Jersey.
And that I will bear true faith and allegiance.
And I will bear true faith and allegiance.
To the same.
To the same.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And to the governments established in the United States.
And in this state.
And in this state.
Under the authority of the people.
Under the authority of the people.
I do further solemnly swear.
I do further solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully.
That I will faithfully.
Impartially.
Impartially.
And justly perform.
And justly perform.
All the duties.
All the duties.
Of the office of prosecutor.
Of the office of prosecutor.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I would like to call forward members of the Fanwood Rescue Squad leadership that will be serving in 2017. We have President Jeff Downing, Vice President and Training Officer Patricia Ruckerty, Secretary Jamie Hedenoff, longtime Treasurer Bob Crothers, Captain Nancy Mustachio, First Lieutenant Robert Villegas, and Sergeant Christian Roman. Okay, did I miss anybody? Ready?
Yes.
Nancy, behind you. Please raise your right hand and repeat after me, and then just place in your name. I. Do solemnly swear. That I will support the Constitution.
That I will support the Constitution.
Of the United States of America.
Of the United States of America.
And the Constitution and the bylaws.
And the Constitution and the bylaws.
Of the Fanwood Rescue Squad.
Of the Fanwood Rescue Squad.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Please give them a nice round of applause. I'd like to call forward the members of the Fanwood Volunteer Fire Company that are here. I'd like to recognize our chief, John Piccola, and our assistant chief, Dave Zwozniak. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Please raise your hand and repeat after me and just put in your name. I.
I, John Piccola.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution and the bylaws.
And the Constitution and the bylaws.
Of the Fanwood Volunteer Fire Company.
Of the Fanwood Volunteer Fire Company.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office of.
The duties of the office of chief.
To the best of my ability.
To the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Please give them a nice round of applause. Next, we will have the adoption of the bylaws for the year 2017. I have a motion, please.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. The next is an appointment of the council to the planning board representing the council as a Class 3 member, Councilman Jack Molinar. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Second. There's a second there. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Every town gets a representative on the Union County Revenue Sharing Committee, the CDBG. Councilwoman Kathy Mitchell has been our representative for many years. Do I have a motion on that?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Next on the agenda, it cannot be stressed how critically important it is for members of this community to step forward and to serve on our various boards and commissions. I am very happy to see so many of our volunteers sitting in the audience today, from the Planning Board to the Library to the Environmental Commission, the Shade Tree, the Board of Health. There is a long list on page 6, 7, 8, and 9 of our agenda. So I'd like to have a motion, and I'd like to add that one of the Library Trustees, Mary Everson, did not make the agenda, so we just need to add her in. She's taken the appointment of Sheldon Ross. Okay, so can I have a motion on that?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. The mayor's appointments to board and commission with council consent for the year 2017. There's several members from the Historic Preservation Commission, the Rec Commission, and the Board of Health, which I see, I think, several Jane and Kathleen Thomas out in the audience today. So I want to thank you for stepping up and continuing your leadership on that committee. May I have a second on that?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. The next several appointments is how we do our business and who we do our business with in the borough of Fanwood. The first resolution will be designating our public meetings for the year 2017. May I have a motion on that?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
The next resolution is designating the official media for the borough in 2017.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
And I just have to do a shout out to our own alternative press, John Mooney, who lives here in Fanwood. With the decline of print media, it has become really still very important to get local news out and what's happening in government. And I think that the alternative press has really done a commendable, fair job since its inception. So we're very glad that you're here and covering what goes on. All in favor on that?
Aye.
A resolution designating the official depositories for the borough funds for 2017.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
We will have a temporary budget, which is roughly 25%, a little over 25% of the total appropriation for 2016 until we actually introduce a budget probably by March.
I'll move the temporary budget.
Second.
I have a second. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. May I have a roll call for that?
The rest of the roll.
Okay.
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington.
Okay. Number 19 is a resolution authorizing a professional service contract for our auditor, Supley Clooney.
So moved.
Second.
May I have a roll call, please?
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington Carey?
The next resolution for professional services insurance broker, general liability and workers' comp to Beckerman and Company.
So moved.
Second.
May I have a roll call?
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
The next resolution is a resolution for professional services for labor council of Roth and Tequani.
So moved.
Second.
May I have a roll call, please?
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington Carey?
The next resolution is professional services for our borough attorney of Rogatin McCarthy.
So moved.
Second.
May I have a roll call, please?
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington Carey?
The next resolution for professional services is for our bond council, which is with Gibbons, Dodeo.
So moved.
Second.
May I have a roll call, please?
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington Carey?
The next resolution is for professional service for special engineering, one to Neglia Engineering.
So moved.
Second.
Roll call, please.
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington Carey?
The next resolution for professional services for special engineering is to Nigerian Associates.
So moved.
Second.
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington Carey?
The next resolution is for special engineering for CME.
So moved.
Second.
May I have a roll call?
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
The next resolution is for professional services for our financial advisor to NW Financial Group.
So moved.
Second.
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
The next resolution for special engineering goes to Suburban Consulting Engineers.
So moved.
Second.
Leslie Hugel?
Yes.
Kathy Mitchell?
Yes.
Kevin Boris?
Yes.
Don Prince?
Yes.
Erin McElroy-Walker?
Yes.
Jack Molyneux?
Yes.
Washington Carey?
The next resolution for professional services for a conflict attorney in the case that we needed with Tujala and Jala.
So moved.
Second.
May I
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for professional services is to a conflict attorney of DeFrancesco abatement.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for professional services for an ethics attorney of DeFrancesco abatement.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for professional service for tax appeal attorney to Colombo Renaud and De Apollonia.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
Next resolution for professional service for tax appeal attorney to Kaczynski, Barron, and Gaffley.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for professional services is for a grant writer to Millennium Strategies.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for professional services for architectural services for the Museo Group.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Next resolution for professional services is architectural services for Contact, Weiss, and Hopkins.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next for professional services architectural SSP Architectural Group.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for video production services to Colonia Productions.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for professional service dental and life insurance to Brown and Brown.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Next resolution for webmaster services, newsletter, and layout for direct developments.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
The next resolution for animal control services to Associated Humane Society.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
And the last resolution for janitorial services to BMI Janitorial, Scotch Plains.
So moved.
Second.
Russell Yugo.
Yes.
Catherine Mitchell.
Yes.
Kevin Morris.
Yes.
John Cranz.
Yes.
Erin Wright-Walker.
Yes.
Deck Malinois.
Yes.
Motion carried.
So that is the professionals that we will be using through the year. Sometimes we give actually more than one under the same contract for engineers or maybe architectural so that we have a pool, so that when we do have a project, we can actually try to get the best number at the time, in case you're wondering why we had more than one architect or maybe one more engineer. At this point, we have council comments, and I would start with our new council president, Kevin.
Thank you, Mayor Marr, and I just want to say Happy New Year to everyone, and congratulations to Tom and Kathy. You both are wonderful, wonderful parts of this council, and we're glad to have you back. I also want to say thank you to all my colleagues for electing me as the council president, and I look forward to working with everybody this year.
Thank you.
Councilman.
Thank you, Mayor. A lot of people I've heard say that 2016 was not one of their favorite years for a lot of reasons. I just want to say that we should, hopefully we can go forward and give those people who we may not agree with the benefit of the doubt and work extra hard at just being nice to each other. I also want to give a shout out to my friends on the rescue squad and the fire department. It's really my privilege to be a volunteer with the rescue squad and to be associated with Chief McCullough and all the guys on the fire department. Being a volunteer in this town has really been one of the highlights of my life, really. Really opened a lot of doors for me here, and I'm just glad to be associated with everybody there. Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year to everyone, and I have a lot to say today. First of all, I need to thank my assistant here. This is Samantha. So she's been helping me turn the pages and everything and learning about government. First of all, we don't get where we are in life without many, many people along the way helping us. So during the past year or so, the mayor has introduced me to other people as the longest serving council person in the history of Fenwick. I am very proud of that. And I guess judging from the amount of votes that I garnered, I think the people of Fenwick kind of agree. So just know that I do what I do because I love Fenwick and I'm here to do the best that I can. But I would like to honor some people who have helped me along the way, who have mentored me, who have had faith in me and challenged me. And the first two, of course, were my mother and my Aunt Marie, who is Samantha's Nana. And then, of course, my favorite person in the whole world was Sister Grace. She was my high school teacher and taught me English. Not only the grammar, but taught me the love of English literature. And to this day, sometimes I'm the only person who knows the answer on Jeopardy when they have an English literature. And then, of course, there are the three women whose the very strong women who you see, whose pictures are on the wall over there. Mayor Pat Curran, who first got me into this when I was serving on the Environmental Commission. And of course, Mayor Stender and former Assemblywoman Linda Stender and Mary Ann Conley. And I think, and of course, my newly departed friend, Joan Wheeler. All of these people who have had a great influence in my life, and without them, they saw things in me that maybe I didn't see and who were there to maybe push me along a little, and so I give them all great credit. And of course, the last one on that list is our current mayor, Mayor Marr. And Russ, I forgive you for giving me wrong information this year. but your credibility is still in the dumps, so you're going to have to work on your credibility. If you watch our council meetings frequently, you will see that Russ and I go back and forth quite a bit. But anyway, on a much more serious note, thank you very much, everyone, and a happy new year.
Thank you very much. Councilman.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm glad Tom is back. Tom, welcome back. Your common sense approach is something that's very valuable and something that we need. Kathy, I can't imagine serving on council without you, and there's a good reason for that. Because it's never happened. So, welcome back, Kathy. Look forward. As far as 2017, I don't have a lot to say because it's a blank page. And I look forward to putting some words on that page with everybody else here. So, Happy New Year.
Thank you. Councilwoman?
So, I guess it's my turn to congratulate Tom and Kathy on your re-inaugurations, and Kevin on your election. I don't have a lot to say. Last year was different. I wrote things down and was very nervous. It's been a great year. I've learned a lot. I think I have a lot more to learn. I'm sitting among really great teachers and advisors and friends, and so I very much look forward to the next year serving this community and getting better at doing this job. So Happy New Year. Stay warm and safe and healthy. That's it.
Thank you. Councilman?
Congratulations, Tom, Kathy. It's good for you to be here. You bring unique voices. We all have different voices up here and different opinions. 2016 was an interesting year for Fanwood Borough Council. We actually disagreed on things. Believe it or not, we can, as all Democrats, disagree on things. So that was, I think it was healthy, and I think that was a good thing, and we got some important things done. And 2017, we have a lot of other things that we need to do as well. And Kathy, just want you to know that we're still here because you asked for company in your second term back in 2003 when Colleen and I were running. You said you were lonely here and you wanted us to run because of that. So I'm still here for you, Kathy.
Oh, thank you. And another thing, Jack, could you not bug me this year?
No, that's my job.
Question?
Thank you, Councilman. The last thing that we will do before we conclude and we head over to the Chelsea for a nice luncheon to start the new year is that I will share with you a couple thoughts that have gone on in the borough in 2016 and look forward to 2017. And when I was starting to think about what to say after being up here for 13 years with these men and women, I also started to think about everything that was recently accomplished in my tenure, but also Fanwood's past. And I came across a quote that I thought was really important as we continue into 2017. And it says, "A people without the knowledge of their past, their origin, or their culture is like a tree without roots," by Marcus Garvey. And as I drive past our train station, which is 143 years old, and it is our oldest and only original station in Union County, I can't help but think that our history and our origin is tied to the railroad into that building. And as I think about the borough of Fanwood celebrating 122 years since it was incorporated, and the evolution of this really small town, and what's taken place over 122 years, and as I think of the men who have served 127 years with the Volunteer Fire Department, and the men and the women over 70 years on the Volunteer Rescue Squad, and the men, and now we can say women, on our Police Department, and the thousands of residents, thousands, who have volunteered over the years, as you and the audience have done, with giving your time and your energy and your creativity to this town, and all the families that have raised their children, who have stayed, who have really given themselves. And I thought about the men and the three women that have served this community and all the council that have come before each of us and the council that will come after us. I am really left with a deep appreciation and really feel like a kindred spirit for all those who have shaped this town into what it is today. So as we proceed into our 122nd year of a governing body. And I look to advance new projects, and we make decisions that use taxpayer-funded dollars, and we create ordinances. We must do so with an eye on our past, on who we are, and what Fanwood's culture is. And that we have a deep responsibility, each one of us, for those who've come before us and those who will come after us. And I really feel like I have come full circle with my commitment to govern in 2017. We always say that charity begins at home, and in 2016, it did that quite nobly. We had an extremely successful Rocking for Autism event, which we partnered with the Scotch Plains Fanwood Youth Baseball Team. And we really brought autism and the challenges that it does to our families front and center, with our recreation department and the baseball and the Banks family. And we have Jerry Cooney, who is one of our most favorite and famous residents, along with Nick's Pizza, hosted their annual holiday party for children with mental health issues and special education needs. And we do our cups for cancer to try to knock out cancer, where we have kids collecting money. And for the first time this year, we actually had a kids' mental health fair, which was extreme success to show that mental health can affect all ages and walks of life. We brought a young woman who proudly carried the flag for her country of Macedonia in the Brazilian Summer Olympics. Anna Bogdanovich was here this year, past year. And those are just a little flavors of what we do. We also continue to spend money on very significant capital improvements, whether it's our road reconstruction, whether it is cutting the ribbon at our first skateboard park, which has been a tremendous success after several years of discussion. We submit money into our tennis courts, and we have spent time and energy and money into bringing back our nature center, which is close to 7 acres of a wonderful nature center, which was taken over by poison ivy and invasive plant species and closed for several years. And we've also had sad events, as Councilwoman Mitchell has said, with the sudden passing of Joan Wheeler and the passing of Don Whistler. And each of us has probably lost someone this year, including the tragic loss of our library director's son, Jesse, who have touched each one of us. And there were good things that happened. Shared services, that's something that we as governing officials, you know, are supposed to do. And I made mention of our recycling. That was probably one of the hottest topics in 2016. And Plainfield and Fanwood forged a great partnership in this past October to begin providing curbside to all of our residents. I'm proud to say we have a higher recycling rate than we ever had before, and our recycling rate was pretty high. I am proud to say that it is convenient for all of our residents, just not some of our residents. We have a great app that has been used countless times. And while we thank 30 years of the nonprofit of the Scotch Plains Fanwood Recycling Association, and that was who Fanwood's past was and defined by, and it was a bittersweet decision, I think that we all believe that it was, we made a successful one and the right choice for our future. 2016 saw a new shared service with the Township of Union, which we were very proud with. We actually now use a qualified purchasing agent from Union, which allows us to have a higher threshold of purchasing power without having to go out for a costly request for proposals. And we are continuing a highly successful Public Works Director shared service with our friends in Garwood. And that shared service really showed the communities that you don't have to be geographically bound to share a significant service. We continue with Westfield with the Board of Health. And this year also, 2016, marked really two great partnerships. A public-private partnership with Community Access for an awesome building on the corner of Terrell and Midway, which was recognized by New Jersey Biz and the New Jersey League of Municipalities with a public-private partnership award, where you put commercial buildings on the first floor and then you put residential. That was a mix of affordable, developmentally disabled, and market-rate housing. And we also joined the Greater Westfield Area Chamber of Commerce this year, which actually was a great boom for our business community. One of the things that really continues to define what Fanwood does and keeps our property value strong, and I think us attractive, is the strong team that we have with our investment in our economic development. And I am pleased 2016 saw us bringing on Liz Jeffrey, who is in the audience today, as our economic development point person. And also, I'd be remiss if I did not publicly acknowledge and thank Ray Sullivan as our zoning officer, who has really worked hand in hand with Liz. And I think that our progress in economic development and investment is marked by progress, progress, and progress. We have new zoning all along South Avenue, which actually will help create and entice businesses to invest. We will also be investing in new sidewalks, and in the Fanwood lamp, and in the streetscape improvements from Tower Road all the way to Sheelan's Crossing. We will take what people like around the train station, and we're going to bring it all the way down the South Avenue corridor. We saw the opening of Fanwood Crossing 3, which is 16 units along the Grand, and like all the other residential communities that have been built here, it's completely sold out since day one. We saw the planning board approval of the Ponzio site, as we like to refer to it, on Second Street, which we hope will have construction in 2017. We will see the former Sun Tavern, which has become sort of rundown and a bit of an eyesore, actually going under a major reinvestment for a daycare called Lightbridge Academy in 2017. We welcomed a lot of new businesses. For a small town, we welcomed a lot of new businesses. Several was Rocco's Ice Cream. We have our own pharmacy in town, Fanwood Pharmacy. It's what the community wanted, the community has it, and now the community needs to use it so that it stays. And we welcome Sheelan's Crossing. The former Dean Oil site, which a lot of us in town have watched over the years, stays stagnant, I know has recently received its planning board reapproval, and we will have 35 high-end townhomes along with 7 affordable units, and we look to break ground in 2017. We've had facade improvements. Everybody likes to see what happened to Ginger Moon, Ginger Sushi, and China Moon, and Golden Hanger. And we see property investment happening. We welcome Jolie Visage, which is another new business that will open across from the train station. We welcome, and I just was there for a very soft opening, to the Houdini Kitchen Laboratory, which is at 25 South Avenue, which is next to CKO Boxing. That will be a sister restaurant of a brick oven pizza place that is currently in Queens. And so this will be another location, which will be opening up shortly. And I have to say, by all accounts, it's going to be a home run. The A&P site, as you know, has been demolished. And that was, again, another bittersweet happening for us to lose an actual supermarket in town and the stress that that has put on all of the residents of trying to where to shop. I can tell you that this governing body tried really hard to try to get another supermarket in, but that was not to be. So we look forward to creating a project that all the residents will embrace, that will see value, and that will continue to set the bar really high on what it looks like. Because we know that part of our success has been the design of what we see in Fanwood. Taxes, taxes, and taxes. Something else that continues to weigh on all of us. But in 2016, we actually saw in Fanwood a tax decrease. Not the first time that we've been able to deliver a tax increase, but the issue that I think all towns struggle with is that the majority of the municipal, majority of the taxes are generated from the school board. So when they create 60% of your overall tax bill and they have an average of a $400 increase, our decrease sort of gets wiped out and it gets muted. And I think that this governing body is going to be very committed this year to working with the Board of Ed, to working with our friends in Scotch Plains, since we are a regional school district, to really make sure that the taxes that come out of the school board are kept stable. Because it's just not for the senior citizens, it's also for the young people, the young families. Because we can't remain affordable if the largest piece of our tax bill is increasing twice as fast as the municipal piece is. So that's going to be something that I know that we have a commitment with and a good working relationship with to keep the taxes stable across the board. This year we'll also see a revaluation of our property taxes happen in town. We are long overdue, as several other communities are in Union County, to do a revalve of our property taxes. We've taken the first step in updating our property tax maps, which will be happening in 2017. We are working closely with the Union County Board of Taxation, who has strongly encouraged us to make sure that this happens. So we will be communicating quite effectively and often with our community to understand what that means. And it's going to be a long process, and I know people can be very skittish about what it means, but right now it is so out of whack with what the reality of the market is that we are really doing the community an injustice by not doing our revaluation. So 2016 also saw us pass our first referendum question in close to two decades. And we created an open space fund, and this will be the first year that we will use some of those funds towards historic preservation and recreation and environmental. I will continue to do coffees with the mayor, which has been very successful. We've done two or three of them in 2016, and it's a nice way for me to keep in touch with the community. For all of our boards and commissions, from our recreation to our planning board to our board of health to our shade tree to our police to our first responders, I want to say thank you. I also want to tell you that I am still actively involved with the Raritan Valley Rail Coalition, and we will be making sure that 2017 sees a little more equity in our service. We are actually going to try to fight to get earlier evening trains out of New York. That is where we believe we can have the next success, because the state of our infrastructure, transportation infrastructure in New Jersey, is abysmal. The tunnels are in bad shape, the platforms at Penn Station need an overhaul, and the idea of us getting probably peak one-seat ride is not going to be happening in 2017. But what can happen is the fight for what we believe is doable things, and earlier evening trains, we believe, is quite doable. So I want to thank each and every one of you for coming out here today and joining a part with our tradition of reorganizing government. I think 2017 is going to be an extremely bright year for all of us. I want to wish everyone good health, good spirits. Remember, as Tom said, to treat each other with a bit of kindness, because what you see that's happening internationally and nationally can sometimes put us in a not so good frame of mind. But here in Fanwood, you know, things are bright and sunny. I am quite honored to be your mayor, and I'm quite honored to sit up here with these men and women and all of the staff. So with that, I wish you a very happy new year and a good 2017. Thank you. I'd like to open the meeting to the public for any members that wish to come forward at this time to make any statements.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'd like to call forward any members of the public. Seeing that there isn't any, can I have a motion to close the meeting to the public?
So moved. Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
And so before we adjourn, I'd like again to extend a personal invitation to join us over at the Chelsea, where we'll be actually having it catered by the new restaurant in town called Fanwood Grill, so that you will actually be able to kind of have a first-hand look at all the great menu items that we will be serving. So with that, I'd like to have a benediction, my father.
Loving and eternal God, we thank you for our civil liberties and freedom, for our opportunities and our privileges, and for those who are elected and called to serve the people. Grant us your continued blessing now and throughout this new year. Amen.
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 Can I have a motion to adjourn? May I have a second?
Second.
All right. Thank you all for coming, and please join us. Thank you for lunch.